Hello friends, how are you all? My name is Balwinder Singh and this lesson is about the functions and the theory of profit. It's part 4, so if you're not gone through the part 1, 2, 3, so kindly go through that so as you can understand this lesson in an efficient way. So friend, in this lesson what we are going to study? The course content of this lesson is the functions of profit and the difference between the business and economic profit. Followed by the present, we are going to present the various theories of profit. The theories of profit is an important aspect of this lesson. And the last one is examine the functions of profit in a free enterprise economy. So we are going to study these four parts in this lesson. All parts are equally important and this video is the conclusion part of this section. So just read the, just learn the facts in a very effective way. And if you have any doubt, then please ask me in the comment box. Now, let's start the lesson from the difference between the business and economic profit. So profit or business profit, one is the same thing we have, that is it refers to the revenue of the firm and if we need to subtract that explicit cost, or we may say the accounting cost of the firm, mean from the revenue of the firm, if we subtract the explicit or accounting cost of the firm, we have the business profit, or we may say the profit. Now in this we have the word called explicit. Explicit cost, we need to understand, explicit cost is the cost, or you may say the actual cost which owner or the entrepreneur pay out of his pocket, like the expenditure to purchase or hire the inputs of production which we require in the production processes. And this expenditure certainly include the wages to hire the labor, interest to borrow capital, rent for the land and building, and the expenditure it incurred on the raw material. So basically the land, labor, capital and raw material, whatever the cost he paid for that, that includes in the explicit cost. And if you subtract that cost from the total revenue of the firm, we have the profit or the business profit. Whereas the economic profit is equal to the revenue of the firm minus explicit and implicit cost. So explicit cost that we discussed in the last slide. Now we need to understand what we have for the implicit cost. So implicit cost refers to the value of input that owned by the entrepreneur and that is used by the firm in own production processes. Mean if an own resource used for the production process, that defines the implicit cost. Implicit cost from mean like the cost. Implicit cost means the salary that an entrepreneur could earn if he works for someone else and with the same capacity, or we may say that the return of the firm that it could earn from investing its capital in somewhere else business and the renting its land and input to the other firms like this. Mean implicit cost mean if these own resources which a person employed in its own production process, if it employed these resources in somewhere else or someone else's business, so whatever the revenue he may have from that, mean by letting out his input to some other business, he got some return on his investment. So whatever the thing he may have by investing his resources in someone else's business, that considers the implicit cost. Because the thing is that input owned and used by the firm in its own production process are not free for the firms. So we can say the firm can use them without any actual or explicit expenditure, but the cost it is having and the cost we have over the own resources, that considered as the implicit cost. So now, accordingly we need to understand the economist. Economists include both explicit and implicit costs in the definition of cost. Because they include normal return of for that implicit cost, they generally include normal return on the own resources at a cost of cost, so that the economic profit of the revenue minus implicit and explicit cost fall. While now we need to understand that the concept of business profit that is useful for the accounting purposes and the tax purposes, whereas the concept of economic profit that we require to have correct investment decision in the firm or in any of the economic activity. So it is very important to have that business profit or profit we have for the accounting purpose and the tax purposes, whereas the economic purposes we have, economic profit we can use to take the best investment decisions. Now let's start with the next concept, which is the theory of profit. theory of profit, we have the profit rates for that certain profit, which is different among the given industries, and even we can say that it's widely we can have for the firms in different industries. I mean, different profit rates we have for the different industries or the different firms we have around the globe. Whereas the firm in the industries like steel, textile, railroads, I mean the production processes, which means huge investment, they earn or may say they work on a very low profit. And the low profit we have in reality with the absolute terms or in relation with the profit that earns by the firm which works in pharmaceuticals, office equipments and high technological industries. So we can say there are several theories which attempts to explain these differences, mean why that heavy industries works on low profit rate and the high technological industries earn huge profit as compared to each other. So there are many theories we have to explain this difference over the profit rates. So let's study these theories one by one. First we have like the risk bearing theory of the profit. The risk bearing theory means that the normal returns are required by the firm to enter or to remain in the field like petroleum exploration, and whereas the average risk similarity with the unexpected return on stock, expected return of stock has higher, mean has to be higher than the bonds because the greater risk of the former. So the thing is, mean if a firm is taking less risk, he have less rate of return. If a firm is bearing high risk, he may earn high profit from that processes. So it is important to say, mean the heavy industry, they are less risk taker, so as they earn very minimum profit, very less rate of profit over the production process. Now the next one is called the functional or the frictional theory of profit. This frictional theory defines or the stress is that the profit arises as the result of friction. Friction or the disturbances that he has from the long run equilibrium, and the long run perfectly competitive equilibrium forms tends to earn only normal return on profit. The thing is that if we have less friction or disturbance in the long run equilibrium, so we can say the firm is earn very less profit or the normal rate of return in respect of their investment and any time. However, the firm's not likely to be in the long run equilibrium may on the profit or incur a loss. So the thing is, if a firm is working on the long run basis, he may earn very less profit, whereas if a firm works on a short term equilibrium, he may earn huge profit and sometime incur the loss as well. So the next theory of the profit is called the monopoly theory of profit. Some firms with the monopoly power can restrict output, and they charge high price than the perfect competition to earn good profits because there are some restrictions, like restriction in the entry of the new industry of this into the industry, and these firms can continue to earn huge profit even in the long run. But monopoly power may arise from the firm going in the controlling the entire supply of the raw material, which is very hard for a firm to have, and it requires the production of the commodity of the economies of large scale of production. So if a firm is having monopoly authority or the monopoly rights, it means that the firm it has only in the field, but to manage that great scale of production, it needs to have economies of a large scale production from the ownership. Apart from this, that the patent and the form of government restriction that prohibited competitions. So many things are to be there to attain that the monopoly rights in the industry, so as a firm can earn huge profit in the long run as well. Now the next one is called the innovation theory of profit. It is a very simple aspect of the firm that the innovation theory of profit that postulate profit is the reward of introduction of the successful innovation. Mean if a new firm is introducing any new innovation in a successful, so that firm rewarded with huge profit in the short run and the long run as well. The next one we have the managerial efficiency of the managerial efficiency in the theory of the profit. This theory that based on the observation that the average firm tends to earn normal rate of return on its investment in the long run, whereas the firms are more efficient than the average could earn more than the normal profit or that profit we can consider as the economic profit for the firm. Mean, if a firm is more efficient in term of management, it may earn more profit than the average profit, which consider as the economic profit for that firm. The next we have the conclusion of that theory of profit. All these theory of profit have some element of truth. Mean, all theories which we discuss have some element of truth, and each may be more applicable to some industry specifically. And indeed, we can say that profit is arise from the combination of the factors. There is no single factor that enhance the profitability of the firm. There are several factors that include the differential risk, market disequilibrium, monopoly power, innovation, and managerial efficiency. So all such things combinedly enhance or somewhere increases the profitability of the firm. So that thing we need to understand. The next is the functions of profit. So profits serve as a crucial role in the free enterprises economy. I mean, free market economy is work through the profit motives, and we can say high profit signals that the consumer wants more of the output of that industry, and it also the incentive for the firm to expand output. Whereas we can say for more firms to enter in the industry, mean it's somewhere if the profit of an industry is high, so it somewhere encourages new firms to enter in that industry too. Whereas the firm in the above average efficiency, the profit represents the reward of greater efficiency. I mean, if a firm is having great efficiency, it may have great returns. Whereas the low profitability, on the other hand, signals that the consumer wants less of the competitive of that firm, and it also defines that the production process in that industry is less efficient or not much efficient to provide that good profits. It also says that a person has to work in a more efficient way to have that incentive over the profit. Mean more efficiency, more profit a firm is earned. So it is all about this lesson. I hope you like this lesson. Whatever the concept I give in this, all five parts are very, very important for the examination point of view, and kindly make some notes on them. Thank you so much again. Have a great day. Bye bye and take care.